I'm here because I was driven out by local town government. Now, what do you call the American dream? Own your own home, which is a myth. You really don't own it. You really lease it from the government. 2003, I went to Limerick, Maine with $35,000, log cabin on 9 acres. I thought that was going to be my place, and I'm going to be free to use it as I see fit. 2008, the town of Limerick, Maine sues me. You can't have more than 2 unregistered vehicles. I've always liked antique and older cars. I have 15 of them on there. You can't have more than 2. They have to be registered. Well, I don't want to register all of them. So I got a $15,000 lien against the house. We were in the district court, superior court, and the federal court. The appeals ran out last May. So coming back on the bus, you can't sue the town either. 1 month ago today, the town came down. I got a call from somebody staying there. The sheriff is here. Tow trucks are here. Moving trucks are here. Machinery is here, and they're taking everything you have. Destroyed 8 vehicles. It cost me $10,000 in savings to save the remaining vehicles. There was no court order to take private property in the garage. So how do I want to live there, oppressed, harassed, intimidated, and in fear of living in a place that I paid for?
Where are you living or staying now?
Right here. You're up the bus. I'm staying here because how can I live in a place where I got to feel intimidated and harassed? And nobody in the media wants to take this story. They don't care. So I said to them, I've called all the media outlets. If I had guns and start shooting, they'll all be there. They'll all want the story. So I'm not in favor of big government. I don't think the government is the answer to all the solutions. It's a problem to many solutions. Now, one of the things this gentleman, I think, didn't mention, why did a lot of companies go overseas? Because of a lot of the restrictions and taxes they put on companies. So if you have a company, you say, I got to do all that, I'm just going to leave. Minimum wage, I'm not in favor of the minimum wage. Why can't you negotiate with the employer and the employer negotiate with you whatever wage you want to work for? So if you have a company, you say to me, I'll give you $5 an hour and I'm willing to take it. What is wrong with that? Right now the government says you can't do that for me. So if you say I can't give you $5, I'll just go overseas and give them a lot less than you do.
Right.
And many other restrictions they place on business. So they make it very hard to do business. I remember Thanksgiving 99, I was locked up for 3 days for selling balloons downtown crossing without a permit.
Three days, yeah.
Wednesday night into Thursday, Thanksgiving into Friday. I finally got out of jail for selling balloons without a permit. So you're not free in this country. Look at the fruit man across the street. He wants to sell his fruit, they won't let him. So I'm asking everybody, I'm not saying you have to agree with it, to look at the website for the Libertarian Party of Massachusetts, and they meet the last Sunday of every month at Joe's Bar and Grill on Newbury Street at 7 o'clock, which they did last night. So a lot of the things these people want, they think the government is the answer. I'm not in favor of the rich paying more in taxes. You know why? If you earned it legally, it should be yours. For every $10 that gets launched through the system, $9 gets launched through the system, only $1 goes to people that need it. What is wrong with encouraging people with money and resources to give directly? When Warren Buffett says the rich should pay more, give it directly to people that need it. That would be more efficient. There are many others. That's why I have always liked the Libertarian Party principles and what this country was founded. Before 1913, it's hard to believe there was no IRS.
Exactly.
How did we live for over 100 years with no IRS?
National tariff import taxes.
Well, okay, there could be net tariffs, yeah, there could be.
What do you expect to come from these protests, and where are you going after this?
One thing I propose, and I hope they will take it, one of the goals, which couldn't be more direct, in 212, we have a president in the White House that is not a Democrat or Republican. Not an Obama, not a slick hair Romney or Perry, not a pizza man, we could buy our own pizza, neither one of those. Now, in the last election in Massachusetts in 2008, how many candidates did we have on the ballot in Massachusetts for president? Do you know the answer?
Quite a few.
Six.
Six.
How many did you hear about? Two.
Two.
This should change. All candidates, no matter what their view is, should have an equal chance of making it, and the media should cover all the candidates. You don't necessarily have to agree with them. So like a buffet, would you buy a car in a store, car store that only had 2 cars on the lot? Would you go on a restaurant that only had 2 items on the menu? So why do you accept only 2 candidates? And you should not be made to feel that you're wasting your vote voting for Tweedledee and Tweedledum. So what you do is, what we have now is a two-party dictatorship. Just as in the Middle East they've thrown dictators out, we need to do the same by voting. So you look at a coin, you say, wow, that's a Democrat. Wow, that's a Republican. It looks different. No, it's the same coin. That's the analogy I like to give. So that's why I'm asking, in 212, look at all the choices and consider voting for somebody other than a Democrat or Republican. If you want to talk to me, my phone number is 857-312-0891. 857-312-0891. I lost everything I had in Limerick, Maine, and I can't live that way. I can go back to the house, but how do I live that way feeling oppressed?
Absolutely. Thank you so much for your time.
Okay. Is that a story you ever heard?
No,
that
have, that's
talk about
great.
Terrorism, Bin Laden, his gang.
Right.
They're coming. At least give me notice you're coming.
Right.
They didn't give me any adequate notice. I was in California at the time. I had to pay $200-something to get the next flight out. I got a taxi fare, $300 cab ride up here. Three in the flight, he left me in the middle of nowhere. 8 vehicles were destroyed.
Wow. That's...
They weren't stolen.
No, they were destroyed.
You can't sue the town because you can't sue the king. So what do I got to do to get justice? Go up there and start shooting? Then all the media will be up there.
Exactly.
I want everybody in the world to know about this story because this is an outrageous, preposterous story. I'm just devastated.
Absolutely. I hope everything works out, and I hope you get something from it.
You can't sue the town.
No.
You're immune.
I know.
I got to think about going to a third world country, probably somewhere in Southeast Asia where I go every year, where the people are a lot freer. It's hard to comprehend. I put the seatbelt in the car when I'm there. What are you putting your seatbelt on for? I see a guy building a house. You have a permit? He says, what do you mean build, have a permit? Is there a building inspector? Who's a building inspector? These people never even heard of these things. They just live.
Right.
And we're so used to the nanny government state, we've got to have all this protection or we're going to be going to hell in a handbasket if we don't have all this. So I see it as not the answer. I see it as a problem. If I want to have a company, take all the regulations off of companies and maybe they'll come back here and manufacture things here.
Exactly. Hey, well, best of luck to you.
Okay, thank you.